I'm live again. I'm so sorry. I don't know why my first live ended. But I'm just gonna wait for people to join again. Okay. So, I was just making sure everyone was ready. Because, again, tonight's live is very exciting. I will be having a special guest. I kind of introduced him earlier already, but then my live ended. I don't know why. But I will see if he is back in the room. Okay. Okay, he's here. Without further ado, please welcome the one and only, the legendary, Callum Scott. Let's invite him to the room right now and see if this works this time around. Is it working? Okay.
Woo! Bro!
That is a beautiful song.
Thank you. Wow. Oh my gosh.
It is gorgeous. How do you pronounce that? Sasagipinkita.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Sasagipinkita. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh.
Beautiful, man. Beautiful. I was just vibing. I was like, woo!
Thank you. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I'm talking to you right now. I mean, we've talked before a bit. But this is the first time we're actually kind of talking to each other. Yeah.
How you doing? You good?
Yeah, I'm good. The internet is kind of a problem where I am right now because I'm at the beach actually with my family, so I'm in the car.
Okay.
My data.
That's so funny. Literally, when you was on Instagram Live, I'm like watching, and then you introduced me, and I'm playing the song, and I'm like vibing. And then I open my eyes and it says, the live has ended. I was like...
I know, I'm so sorry.
I was like, oh, he must have hated the fact that I played his music.
Oh, thank you so much for playing it, though. It means a lot.
So welcome. But yeah, man, I just want to say I'm a big fan of your music. Obviously, I saw you did the duet on TikTok of Heaven. And then just started looking into all of your stuff. And I mean, you're like one of the most successful Filipino pop stars, right?
Oh, thank you. I wouldn't say that, but it means a lot coming from you. Thank you so much.
I mean, bro, you're like 3.5 million on Instagram or whatever it is. And then like 2.3 million on TikTok. Like, your numbers are crazy, but it's because you've got such an incredible voice.
Thank you. It means a lot. And of course, I've been following you since, like I said earlier, before my other live ended, since your Britain's Got Talent journey. And You Are the Reason is really one of my favorite go-to songs. Like, when I need that extra pump, you know, like, that extra bit of inspiration and hope. So, thank you so much.
Bro, my pleasure. It's crazy to me that You Are the Reason has traveled as far as it has. You know, like, you dream as a music artist to be able to go to a country that you've either never been before or rarely been to, and to sing a song and for people to sing those words back. And especially my time in the Philippines, as soon as I got to sing You Are the Reason, everybody's phone comes up. And like for me, I thought that Dancing on My Own was going to be the only song that people recorded, because obviously that was where I was discovered and that was kind of my breakthrough song. But I didn't know if one of my own songs would have that effect. And the fact that as soon as I sing You Are the Reason, everybody seems so excited to like sing along and film it. And it just fills me with like confidence, you know, as an artist. So I'm so glad that you like You Are the Reason. It's a special
one. Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, aside from the actual song, I feel like it's definitely because of your voice as well, because it has such a unique tone and texture where you just really feel the emotion a lot more because it's your voice as well singing it.
Thank you.
So, yeah.
Thank
definitely
you,
definitely one of my favorites.
Oh, stop it.
Yeah, but of course, I have a new favorite. I have a new favorite single of yours. It's called Heaven, and it's out right now.
Yeah, bro. It's a beautiful song, you know. And I think the thing that I love about this song is that it puts the power in the relationship. It makes like, you know, the fact that I mean, the lyric says, you know, if everybody, if people had a love like ours, then they wouldn't call above heaven because heaven's what I've got with you. And I just think that sums up the song so beautifully. And it puts the power back in there. It's like you're never gonna find a love more powerful in the universe than what you have with that other person. And I think if you can find that with somebody, then you know that's what dreams are made of, right? So I think it's a beautiful song. And then I see, and then I put this like challenge out, like, oh, you know, duet the song. And then I see you singing it, and I'm like, well, he's singing it
Oh no. Definitely
better
disagree with that. Thank you though,
Oh,
bro. Thank
bro.
you.
Honestly, I think it sounds perfect. I think our voices on that duet together just sound so beautiful. I mean, who knows? Maybe we should get in the studio and record a version.
Oh yeah, I would love that.
That'd be
Hopefully
cool,
very
right?
soon.
That'd be
Yeah.
cool.
I'd love to do
Wait,
that. And
are you based in the Philippines?
yeah, I'm based in the Philippines right now, but I was born in Calgary, Alberta, in Canada, and I
Awesome.
came to the Philippines to join the Voice Kids back in 2014, and the rest is history. I've just been singing a lot here in the Philippines and doing my own thing as well.
I love the fact as well that you know, we've both got that relatability of being on a TV show. You know, I don't know if that's
Yeah.
where you had your first kind of boom. But for me, for sure, I was kind of doing local things and, you know, I was performing in like little clubs and little pubs here in the UK, and did a couple of competitions. And then my sister auditioned us for Britain's Got Talent. And that's kind of where everything started to take a bit more of a boom, and then releasing my version of Dance on My Own as a single was just when it just went crazy. So it's cool to share that with you in the fact that you've been on a show, you know, The Voice Philippines, you've been through that kind of machine. And what I love is the fact that you've made a career out of it. I think sometimes it can be quite difficult after the show to really stick around, you know, because there's you know, it's hard, but you've done it so well, and you've got, I mean, you've got ridiculous numbers,
Oh, thank you.
and that all comes from, you know, that all comes from your voice. I mean, I can see already, like, so many people just want to say hi to you and want to show you their love, and you know, that's such a beautiful thing, man. It's such a beautiful thing.
Thank you so much. Well, I feel like it also helps in a way that we both came from reality competitions because I feel like it doesn't get more real than that. Like that's where people really got to know us and we can't really fake much on, you know, reality TV. So I guess that's one of the things that, you know, our supporters like the most as well is the authenticity that they got from that. And in a way, it kind of became a better connection. Like we became more connected with our followers as well. And that's why I'm just so grateful to all of my fans, you know, the Darenatics who've been there since day one. And that's why the numbers just are so high because of them as well.
Well, and like you said, I think, you know, when you're a very normal person, you've had a very, you know, normal upbringing, and then you go on a talent show, like you go from that kind of, you go on there hoping for the best, hoping to do a good job, and then all of a sudden you're just catapulted into this place where people want to like talk to you about your music, talk to you about your aspirations. People want to know about your personal life. It's like all of a sudden you're like held in such high regard, but you're the night before the audition or the night before the show, you're just a regular guy walking around the street. You know, everything's fine. I think I've tried to retain a lot of that normal kindness. Like I still have a, you know, I still live up in my hometown. You know, I still see all of my friends from school. Like I try and be a normal person, you know. And I think people online see that, and I think, you know, people, real people relate to real people. So I think that's why you know, that's why both of our audiences are, you know, so zoned in and so loyal and just incredible. I mean, I'm trying to speak and I can just see so many comments, so many beautiful comments coming up about you. It's awesome, man.
Oh, thank you.
It's really cool. Everybody, oh, what I will say, Darren, is everybody that I can see is saying, do a collab, perform a collab.
I know.
So maybe we'll have to give them what they want, maybe.
Oh yeah, definitely. I'm ready anytime. It's
as soon as we're finished at the beach, we'll get you in the studio.
Oh yeah. thank you. Oh my gosh, I'm just so excited. I cannot wait. And hopefully, you know, whenever you're free, you can come to the Philippines as well, and we can tour you around, and you know, maybe collaborate in person as well.
100%, bro. I would love to. I mean, it's been a long time since I've been able to get back to Asia, obviously because of the pandemic and the regulations and all that kind of stuff. But now that things are easing up a little bit, I might have an announcement that I'm playing in Asia. Who's to say? I can't tell you too much. But once we're in a position to be able to say about shows in Asia or me coming back and touring, I would love to have you at the show, bro. I'd love to have you there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well,
Oh, sorry. I might be a bit laggy. I know you've been to the Philippines before as well.
Yeah, bro. I performed in, where was it? In the New Frontier Theatre.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, 2018 is part of my Only Human tour. I performed there, and it was an amazing show, man. I mean, the thing I love about the Philippines is that the people really do love music. Like, they turn up, they're screaming, they're clapping, they're like, they sing along with all the words. Like, they're such an appreciative audience. And I love that about the Philippines, you know, and it's a crazy country, and I love it. And as soon as I'm back, bro, we should definitely do something.
Oh yeah, definitely. I would love that. And a lot of people are also commenting that they were at the New Frontier Theater.
Oh, amazing!
In Manila, yeah.
That's so very cool. That's,
yeah,
very
shout
cool.
Shout out to everyone who was there back in 2018. And of course, I want to ask you as well, what have you tried in the Philippines, like in terms of food? Have you tried any authentic Filipino dishes?
I forget because I've been to so many different places that everything starts merging. I'm like nasi lemak, but I'm pretty sure that's Indonesian.
Oh yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I'm like, what have I eaten from the Philippines? I don't know, what would you recommend is the best things to eat there?
Well, I mean, my favorite will always be adobo. I mean, any type of adobo for me is always good. So okay. I feel like that's the first thing that you should try, adobo.
And would you eat adobo in the evening, in the morning, in the afternoon, like all three?
Yeah, you can eat adobo any time of the day, which is why everyone loves adobo, like a lot of people.
Okay, I'm gonna have to get myself some adobo. I'm just gonna Google it so I can find out what it looks like.
Oh yeah, for sure.
All right, okay.
There's chicken, there's pork, so it comes in a lot of varieties actually too. And apart from adobo, you should also try some Filipino street foods, which some people are commenting as well.
Yeah, I really, really want to come back and have some street food, because every time I've been to the Philippines, I've kind of been like in, do the show, back out again. But I would love to, like, you're going to have to be my tour guide, Darren.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Me,
you're going to have to be my tour guide.
The UMG team, we're going to tour you around Manila.
Yes.
For sure.
Yeah. Let's get in the tuk-tuk and go get some street food.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. Street food and adobo.
Yes.
I will ask the UMG team for us to, because I've never ridden a Filipino Jeep before. I've never ridden a Jeep in the Philippines, so that's something that I feel like both of us should do for the first time.
We need to manifest. We need to manifest and make it happen.
Yes. Manifesting for that. It's a very, I believe in manifesting as well.
Yes, same. Same. But listen, man, I don't want to take too much of your time. I think I do want to say the duet that we did on TikTok just was so good. And, you know, if we get the opportunity, I mean, a lot of people are saying that we should collaborate. I would love to collaborate properly. I mean, we'll let the guys work it out, but I would love to do something with you in the studio, because you've got such a nice voice that really works well on a recording, you know? It's like you can hear the tone and the clarity, and like your range is beautiful. And I like, even from that one TikTok video, like I could just see what you brought to it. It just brought a different thing. And one thing I will say to Darren is that I have said for the longest time that I would love to do a duet with another guy, because I've done Leona Lewis, we recorded You Are the Reason together. And then I recorded I'd sang with artist from The Voice Germany, and we've sang Rise together. I've done a collaboration with a French artist called Barbara Pravi, but very rarely have I done a duet with a guy. And like, you've got like the perfect voice for me to duet with. So we're going to have to make it happen.
Oh yeah, definitely. Thank you so much. That means so much coming from you. And hopefully, you know, let's again manifest for this to actually happen.
I'm manifesting it. Listen, enjoy the beach, bro. Say hi to your family for me. Say Mabu hi.
Thank you. Yeah, definitely. Thank you so much. And of course, take care. And I hope that one day you can come to the Philippines. And again, manifesting for this collab to actually happen. So thank you so much.
And a massive thank you to your fans. A massive thank you to my fans. Watch this space. Who knows?
Yeah. Thank you so much, Callum. Nice.
Thank you, bro.
To talk with you and meet you and everything. Thank you so much.
Thank you, brother. Take care, man. See you soon.
Thank you. Bye.
Thanks, bro.